Hey YouTube, welcome to another video on personal knowledge management. I've been tracking Remnote for quite some time now, and I really believe it's one of the top-notch note-taking tools out there. It's a serious player against the more popular apps out there. Today's video is all about exploring what makes Remnote unique and why it could be the perfect note-taking app for you. Let's dive in. Remnote is packed with features. I mean, it looks like they've left no stone unturned when it comes to functionality. Except for one, more on that later. We'll go through the standout features and how they might level up your workflow. Just a short update, something funny happened while making this video as Remnote CEO Martin Schneider reached out to me and showed me some of the new features of the tool. So stick around and I'll show you what came with Remnote's latest big update. First off, we need to tackle the big one. The integrated spaced repetition tool. It's by far the most important feature Remnote brings to the table. You can make a new flashcard anywhere in your notes. Say you're studying material for a lecture, you can simply create a node and turn it into a flashcard with double angle brackets. Just fill in the front and back and you're set. You can also customize your flashcards with things like multi-line cards, list answer cards, and closes. You can even add images, but you'll need the pro version of the app for that. To review your flashcards, you just pick flashcards from the side menu. This takes you to the flashcards home, a recently revamped dashboard. Here you can check out your stats and start practicing with the Practice Today's Cards button. This dashboard's goal is to keep you engaged with your cards, and I think it's a fantastic addition to an already great app. What really excites me about the flashcards feature in Remnote is how well it works on mobile. I usually stick to the desktop for organizing my notes, but the mobile app comes in handy for jotting down quick notes on the go. Now, whenever I have a moment with my phone, I can easily review my flashcards on the Remnote mobile app. It's super handy. If you're coming from other note apps, Remnote does a great job of importing notes. They've got an import wizard for most of the popular note apps and formats out there. Plus, they offer the option to export your notes in Markdown, which is really cool because you can easily switch your notes out of Remnote if you decide to change apps. Remnote does a solid job with their cloud service. Your notes get backed up and you can use Remnote on the browser, their app, and their mobile app while all your notes are synced smoothly. If you're not big on storing your notes online, Remnote lets you store your notes locally without any backup. I love how they've considered all the different needs of their users.
If you're finding this video useful, consider clicking like as it helps the channel out. Thanks.
One more thing I've got to talk about is PDF annotations in Remnote, a feature they've recently upgraded. They've managed to create what might be one of the best PDF annotator experiences out there. To use it, just upload a PDF into a new node, and with a click, it opens in a new pane. You can highlight text right there in the PDF, and even copy those highlights over to your notes. Plus, you can add notes to your highlights, which are then stored in the highlights pane, viewable as individual nodes. It keeps a link to the highlight in the document, so when you click on it, it takes you right to the source. Like any content in Remnote, you can also make flashcards directly from your highlights. Keeping track of your progress through a document is easy with the progress bar, and you can highlight notes quickly with the auto highlight feature. All these features are designed to help you go through your source material with minimal hassle. It's honestly the best highlighting experience I've come across. These are tables and tags, features that will seriously up Remnote's game in terms of project management. To start off, create a tag with a double hashtag, like #projects. Once that's done, a table automatically pops up at the bottom of the tag page. You can add multiple properties to this table and customize them in various formats. For example, you can include a date field to track project deadlines. You can also add items directly to the table. Each new item creates a new document where you can edit the properties. Whatever changes you make will show up in the table as well. This feature takes Remnote up a notch. You can use it to add metadata to your notes and even link other notes as a property element with the multi-select option. Beyond the table view, you can create templates inside specific tags. You do this using the configuration panel. Now, whenever you apply the tag to any rem, you can either apply the template automatically or set it manually. With this update, tags become ever more powerful. This is something similar to what Tana is creating with the super tags. If you haven't seen my video on Tana, there is a link up in the corner, go check that out. Honestly, I could go on about all the features and use cases, but I want to keep this video concise. What I will say is that this feature lets you create dashboard home views. This is a game changer because it lets you organize all your work in one view, making it way easier to find whatever you're working on. There's a ton more features to explore, although some do require a paid subscription like the graph view. The graph view gives you a visual of all your notes, super helpful for seeing how they all connect in your vault. If you want unlimited uploads and the full experience of the PDF annotator, you'll need to shell out about 10 euros a month or 72 a year. The help menu is really well integrated as a chat window, so finding any help documentation is a breeze. Like many note apps, there's a slash menu where you can quickly access different styling options and other features. If you're more of a keyboard user, you can quickly get to these with what they call shortcode or a few letter keyword that allows for quicker access. Just type and continue with the shortcode. Remnote has another cool feature called the Omnibar. You can get to it using Ctrl plus K or CMD plus K. The Omnibar lets you navigate your notes and apply commands to multiple notes at once. You can also access what they call power-ups, which are commands that allow for different actions in Remnote, like creating a to-do or adding a document to an edit later status. Basically, Remnote's got everything covered.
Remnote really nails it with a polished experience, top-tier PDF annotation, and arguably the best mobile note-taking app experience. I currently use Remnote as my main flashcard tool because it's a really smooth way of creating and reviewing flashcards. Although Remnote does not currently have a visual whiteboard tool, it's one of the most requested features from the community, so I'm hopeful they'll include it in their future updates. But even without it, Remnote is definitely one of the best note-taking experiences out there. Sure, there are great free alternatives like Obsidian and Logseq, but if you want a seamless note-taking experience geared towards students and learners, you gotta check out Remnote. And with the upcoming features of tables, tags, and templates, the triple T, the product gets a serious upgrade, which contends with the other tools out there. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you wanna see more content like this in the future, consider subscribing. I'll catch you in the next one. Goodbye.